We spoke to Anna Rafferty of Johnson & Johnson about the company's Why STEM 2D program and why it's important to actively support women in STEM. So, Anna, why is supporting women in STEM a priority for Johnson & Johnson at the moment?
At Johnson & Johnson, we really believe that if we're going to serve the needs of our customers, our patients and our consumers, that we really, you know, need to have a diverse workforce that really, reflects the world around us. And as a leading healthcare company, you know, we really wanted to strengthen our commitment to women in STEM. So back in 2015, Johnson & Johnson launched a global program called Women in STEM 2D. Really with the objective of creating a more diverse scientific community.
With the Women in STEM program then, what does that actually offer to people?
We focus on three distinct groups of people, or pillars as we call them. The first pillar is the youth pillar, where we focus on girls that are under the age of 18. This is a really important group for us, because if you think of, you know, school children, we really want to pique their interest in STEM and really to ignite that spark. So we have a lot of Johnson & Johnson employees that would go into schools, carry out workshops and really engage and capture the children's imagination in relation to STEM 2D. And we have a great partner in Junior Achievement here in Ireland as well. The second pillar is the undergraduate program. So this is where, you know, women have actually already chosen STEM 2D courses in universities. So here in Ireland, we partner with the University of Limerick and University College Cork. Women can apply to be part of this YSTEM 2D programme, and the successful applicants then are given a J&J mentor. So they have somebody that they can talk to about what working in STEM 2D is like, or if they have any, you know, concerns about, you know, what a career in STEM would look like. They really have somebody, close by who can answer those questions for them. The final pillar that we focus on in relation to women in STEM is the women who are already, you know, working in professional STEM 2D roles. We are so committed to ensuring that there are development programs in place for those women, because we really want to retain them as well and make sure that they can flourish and really, continue on in their careers in STEM 2D in Johnson & Johnson or other companies.
What advice would you give to other companies who kind of want to roll out a similar program or a similar initiative?
The advice that I would give is, you know, don't focus on raising awareness. You know, everybody knows that the lack of women, in STEM is a problem. So what I would say is, you know, be an actor, not an ally, and do get out there and get active. But I think also, join forces with others. Don't try and do it on your own. We're very involved with the OECD and making sure that we're contributing to their wider efforts. You know, we also took part in the Global Women's Forum last year, and we're very involved with IBEC as well. So I think and clearly our academic partnerships are really important in this instance. So yeah, so get active, partner with others, and make sure you know exactly where you want to make a difference.
Thanks, Anna, so much.
Thanks very much, Lisa.